Let's run a FET example. Start FET and select file open. You will find a lot of examples in the FET examples folder. Let's check a German secondary school example. You can see that this dataset uses 5 days per week and 6 hours per day. So there are 30 time slots per week. You can see a lot of subjects. The subject names are shortcuts only. Of course you can write full names, but I recommend shortcuts, because this way the timetables and the user interface won't be too full. There are also a lot of teachers. I used random names to anonymize and to give new users a better chance to notice that these names are teachers. But shortcuts are recommended here, too. The student's structure might be a bit puzzling for new users, since it is different from other timetabling tools. I will explain them in another video. You might understand it better if you also check the activity planning interface. You can see the activities in the activities list. Tanger is teaching 4 hours maths in class 5A. Nut is teaching 4 hours maths in class 5B. You can also see all constraints that will be respected if you generate a timetable. I will explain them in another video. Normally you should check the statistics before generating the timetable. But the sample file doesn't contain critical bugs anymore. I will explain how to check that in another video. Let's check the activity planning interface before generating. There are 2 tables. The upper one displays all subjects from left to right and all students from up to down. You still remember. Tanger is teaching 4 hours maths in class 5A. Nut is teaching 4 hours maths in class 5B. You can see that the students of class 5A have got 28 hours per week. But the students of that year are also divided into a course. So some hours are in courses. So they have got in total around 29 to 30 hours per week. In the bottom table are all teachers from left to right. You can see that Alex is teaching 26 hours per week. He is teaching 16 hours maths and 10 hours sports. You can also see the number of hours per student set. I will explain this interface more detailed in another video. We can't check a timetable now, because we didn't generate it yet. So let us start generating. You can see that 589 activities must be placed. You can also see the current number of placed activities. Don't worry if the number of placed activities is going up and down. That is normal. Of course, the needed time to generate a timetable is depending on your dataset and constraints. But even with exactly the same settings, the time will be different. There are 4 different actions you can do without stopping generating the timetable. They might help you if you have got a difficult dataset. I will explain them in another video. As soon as the timetable is solved, you can check the timetables. Let's check the teachers' timetables. Agnes will have got always a random free day. Jan will have got free always on Monday. Let's check the students' timetables. You remember. Class 5AM has got 28 hours per week in the class. But the students are divided into a course with 1 to 2 hours. As you can see, FET cared nicely about that. Unsatisfied with the timetable. Maybe Jan needs free at another day. Let's change that. We only change the day and generate again. Happy timetabling.